out there and welcome to my voice. In this video, we shall be looking at the level of marginalization of Southern Cameroons by La Republique du Cameroon, as presented by Eddie Boy. Stay tuned and follow me. The Anglophone Cameroonians have a problem. Some say the Anglophones don't have a problem. Others say they have a problem, but they have the same problem with the Francophones. At the end of this video, we shall be able to deduce whether they have a problem, they have the same problem with the Francophones, or they don't have a problem at all. It all started here in 1961 in Fulham, when they welcomed us with sweet words. How nice it is to meet our brothers. As you see the inscription on the banner behind them, little did we know all these were to render us handicapped and porous. They have hinged us like a door for us to be pivoting at the same spot. But this is going to end very soon. Everything they have done to us is adverse. Ignorant of the fact that I have some good friends that are coming from the Francophone zone, I will invite America to come and destroy this bridge at Mongo and build a very thick and high wall. No links at all. And La Republique would pay for it. Let us now go a little bit retrospective to look at some institutions in the Southern Cameroons that were maliciously closed down by La Republique. The first on the list is the West Cameroon Electricity Corporation, PowerCam. PowerCam is a dam that was built in Yokemuyuka to supply electricity to the whole of the Southern Cameroon and even beyond. It was capable of making us power independent. But everyone was dumbfounded when it was intentionally closed down by La Republique du Cameroun so that we will continue to depend on them, on energy. And that is what we are not having today. As we frequently spend days without electricity on our zone, he saw the first chartered electrical engineer by name Mr. Ebaetro Akpotoko Mbiwan, who was installed the first general manager by President Ahmadu Ahidjo himself, as you can see on the pictures. He reigned from 1962 to 1968. May his soul rest in peace. The next is the Cameroon Bank. Cameroon Bank was an Anglophone bank that was created by Dr. Jongu Francha himself, the biggest in the Cameroons and one of the fastest growing banks in the whole of West Africa at the time. It was also intentionally killed and buried by La Republique. The list continues with the marketing board, which was a board meant to process and greet cash crops like cocoa and coffee, Southern Cameroons. It informed the Anglophone farmers of their grade of their cocoa and coffee before it was shipped to the world market. It was also a powerful organization, financially healthy, and was sponsoring big football teams in the Anglophone Cameroons like Kamak Bamenda and Kamak Kumba. It was also brought down, damaged, killed and buried by La Republique du Cameroon. What a sad situation we have gone through. Next is the Cameroon Cooperative Societies, which was a Dutch culture implanted in Anglophone Cameroon. It supported farmers financially and materially. Farmers work in cooperative groups.
Killed and buried.
You think the list is exhausted?
Oh, not at all.
Public Works Department, PWD, was Southern Cameroon's identity of heavy road construction equipment placed at the doors of the council for road maintenance and repairs. It also sponsored football clubs like PWD FC of Bamenda and PWD FC of Kumba before observing a closure by La Republique. Tiko and Bali airports were among the fastest growing airports at that time in the whole of West Africa, maliciously closed down by La Republique. Tiko Waf was a water link transport between West Cameroon and Nigeria, which was fast growing into the status of a seaport. It was also closed down since they never wanted us to be independent in any way. Let us now take a look at Fonat. Fonat was a special bank created in Anglophone Cameroon to subsidize Anglophone farmers, both financially and materially. It was later transferred to Yaoundé and the name was changed to Crédit Agricole. Today, it can no longer be heard of as mismanagement has caused its collapse. Let's take a look at Mobile Wing. Mobile Wing was a British trained force for Anglophone Cameroon. It was later dissolved and replaced by French gendarmes. Take a look at Ndu and Toleti estate that used to be very wonderfully known. These have been brought down to nothing. Only God will help us. Take a look at the price. It has been refused projection. They prefer to be importing chemical rice that could cause a lot of havoc in our health. They have intentionally embarked on spending a lot of money developing shallow seaports that are found in their zone in lieu of taking care of limber deep seaport that needs only a small touch to serve the nation in a very wonderful way. What a supreme level of marginalization. Take a look at Menchum Fall. Menchum Fall has attracted a lot of foreigners, call them tourists. But it has not attracted a lot of public to Cameroon. They keep admiring it because they know that it could generate electricity that could serve in Cameroon and even far beyond. But they have intentionally abandoned it and they have embarked on spending money developing small dams here and there because they are found in their zone, which will not even supply us enough energy. Let's take a look at Econa Agricultural Research Center that was created by Americans. Later, it was francophonized. And today, it is a sham. We can only see a building standing. Medino in Bamenda used to train farmers. They used to move from one place to another, training farmers and educating them on new farming methods. Ombe Trade Center used to have heavy industrial equipment that were used in fabricating spare parts and making other machines. It was also brought down to nothing. The next institution they are now plotting to dissolve is our consortium. But God is our strength. Martin Luther King Jr. teaches us something about freedom. And I quote,
"Freedom is never voluntarily given by the oppressor. It must be demanded by the oppressed."
End of quote. The only institutions they can never dare to close down in southern Cameroon are Sonora and CDC, which benefit them 100%. We do not benefit anything from these institutions, though they are on our soil.
But God is our strength. A luta continua. Victoria è certa. God be our strength.